They live here at the USGA Museum in Far Hills, New Jersey, celebrating an achievement of extraordinary significance. These clubs and this ball linked to a man who forever changed the game in our country. It could all be traced to one golf course and one hole 100 years ago. It sits adjacent to the corner of Clyde and Lee, just past the club entrance and through the bushes that have grown over the decades, the most important hole in American golf history. This grass, that bunker, and the rocky earth of the country club. Would this ground matter as much if it weren't for the kid who grew up across the street and shocked the world with his victory in the US Open? And as we celebrate this centennial, what draws us even closer to it are these clubs and this ball, artifacts that remind us of the momentous achievement. Francis Ouimet stood on the brink of greatness and watched his birdie putt disappear into the hole on the 17th green in the final round to force a playoff. Feel the grips, touch the putter, appreciate the ball, and then hear the roar of the crowd, unmistakably rooting for the kid from Brookline. Then again the next day, these clubs, carted around by a 10-year-old boy, Eddie Lowry, found glory one more time. Of course, it was on this hole, the 17th, that Ouimet could see from his bedroom window. Francis asked his clubs to answer the call one more time, and they did. Another birdie, the final blow to the great Varden and Ray. And while the visit back to this hallowed ground they once connected with was brief, these clubs and this ball will forever be immortalized along with Ouimet's story from that moment when the greatness of American golf began.